Hey, welcome back to the Conversion Clinic. In this video, I'm going to show you how to do keyword research for Google Ads. It's super easy. All you need to do is open up Google Keyword Planner. Okay, it's free. Connect with your Google account. You're good to go. And then open up a notepad. That easy. So what we're going to do, I've opened up a random law firm in Brisbane, and I might just want to like push their maybe two services just to show you how I would separate them. And also this mattress company. So let's do an ad group for each, as though we're going to do a search ad for each one. Okay, so what we're going to do is we know the page. So we're going to start with this one. We've got divorce. So we're going to just open up this one, divorced lawyer. We might set it up where we're going to list out all our keywords and list out all our negative keywords. So we're just going to copy that, add a new notepad, and we're going to do the same for family law, this other one. And let's say for argument's sake, for the last one, we did one for king size mattresses. Okay, stick with me. It'll make sense in a sec. So what we do is we go back here and we say, okay, it's a landing page. We need to send traffic to it. We need to send good quality traffic, people who are kind of ready to take that next step with this business. And so how do we do that? So we know it's around divorce, and we know it's around divorce law. It's inside family law, so that's interesting. We just need to find keywords around this. So we're going to go to Google Keyword Planner. I use a tool, by the way, called Google Keyword Getter. You might need that. And what you want to do is set your location. So I know that this location is in Brisbane. I might say divorce lawyer near me, divorce attorney near me, divorce legal services. That's a little bit more broad, but let's just do this for now. Okay, you're getting some ideas. So just ignore everything, like literally ignore all this stuff. Don't worry about it for now. I just want to show you how I kind of like select my keywords. So I kind of select them based on intent. Okay, so I see if there's any search volume. If there's any search volume, that's a plus. If the keyword has high intent that they're ready to buy right now, that's a plus too. And then like as a secondary measure, I kind of check this out to see if it's too expensive for me to bid on. But all things aside, let's ignore that for now. Sometimes the fact that you might have most of them ranging between $5 and $15, and that might be the norm. And I'd be like, okay, well, that's normal. I'm going to bid on those. But anything outside that's an outlier, like $30 or $34, I might not want to bid on that because it's too expensive for me, like outside my budget. Anyway, so let's say, for example, you had unlimited budget. I'm just going to show you which keywords you would pick. Keywords I would pick for this one is divorce lawyer near me, divorce attorney near me, divorce legal services zero, so I'm not going to. Best divorce lawyers near me. So if it said best divorce lawyers and no near me, I wouldn't pick it. Simply because people would just go to some sort of list article. I don't want to bid on those kind of options, so I'm going to leave that. Cheap. This firm is not cheap, so they do not want to bid on that kind of stuff. So you might add that as a negative keyword. So you might go here, you might go cheap, you might say affordable. You don't want to attract people who are going to like be tire kickers. So that's why I'm doing that. Now, it says family solicitors in here. Since we're going to create another ad group, family lawyer, I'm going to add that as a negative keyword. We don't want family in here. And likewise, in this one, we don't want divorce in here because we don't want these two ad groups to overlap each other. Big thing, okay? I'd add these as broad match negative keywords, okay? Big tip there. And so I'd probably pick 5 or 10 more keywords. Military divorce lawyer, awesome. So that you could actually create a new ad group for that if it made sense. It doesn't right now because there's no search volume, so that's fine. And then top 5, blah, 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 okay? Let's not get into the rest of it. Let's just say that we picked 10 of these keywords. We've got 3 right now, so I'm going to pick a few more just to show you any examples if I can. Okay, let's do that. So the bottom, this shows up only when you've got this extension here called the Google Keyword Getter. I'm going to select phrase match because we want to do phrase, and I might put that there. And then that's one campaign done, ready to go. You're never, and I'm going to say this again, you're never going to get a ad group perfect. It just never happens. You never get it perfect right out of the gate. So be okay that you've got it 80% of the way there, and your job is to refine it over time. Like add more keywords, add negative keywords, etc. Make it more profitable. That's your job. Okay, so let's say we did family law now, and we do just do the same kind of thing, right? You might just want to double check in here. Family. I don't know why I got rid of the last one. Okay, so family lawyer near me, family legal firm, whatever it is. Okay, let's just type that in. And so the point here, and I mentioned this earlier, is that you don't want to bid on a divorce type of keywords. So you might want to just do like move on to here, make sure divorces are negative, and then you go through the rest of it. You might want that one, you want that one, that's good. Custody lawyers, now I'm not sure if custody would be the right one, you might want to do that as a separate ad group. Child support lawyers, so that would probably be in a separate, another different ad group, because we're doing family related keywords, not child related keywords. So you need to separate it like that. Family court lawyer, family law lawyers, that's what people are typing in, family law solicitors, all this kind of stuff. The rest of it, don't bid on that. You'd probably want to add child in here. You'd probably want to add, what else? Adoption in here, because I see adoption down here. You might want to add cheap and affordable. If you're always never going to bid on these two, you just add as an account negative keyword. That's what I recommend. I've got a video on that, by the way. What else? I think that's pretty much everything. Then what you do is you do the same thing. You select up to 5 to 15. You select as phrase, and that is your keywords done and dusted for that. Now, another example is king size mattresses. So you might go to a page like this, and you might have a page for king size. These are king single. You might have double. You might have queen, king. Okay, so this is king. And so I might want to separate these into their own unique ad groups so they don't overlap each other. So the way you kind of do that is if you're doing king mattress, let's say you do king size mattress or king mattress, you would then make sure by default that you do single, you don't want it to enter into double or queen. And so that helps you not overlap each other. And likewise, if you did a queen, you make sure you add king in there, if that makes sense. Now for this one, you might type in different keywords entirely. You might set the country to Australia wide or wherever you want it. And you might want to do like king mattress for sale. We're going to do buy king mattress online, buy king mattress. And then we're going to open up that. So king mattress for sale, we bid on that, bid on that. These have high intent that someone's ready to like buy something right now. King size mattress sale. Cheap, you might want to get rid of cheap, it's up to you. You might want to get rid of, what are the words, deals maybe, unless you want to bid on that. Alaskan, that might be a brand name, so you might add that as here. Black Friday deals, you might want to add that as a negative keyword, so you don't bid on that. And then for the rest of it, you might not want to, since you sell mattresses, you don't sell used mattresses, so you get make use there, and then secondhand, you don't want to bid on that. And then prices, sometimes I don't bid on prices because sometimes it just attracts tire kickers. So what we might do is we might just put prices in there. Now that's pretty much it. That's all there is to that. And I might just keep adding more to it over time. But for now, I might just go phrase match and then bingo. Now, normally I would spend a lot more time going through this, but for the sake of keeping this video shorter than I wanted, we're gonna stick with that. So that's pretty much everything you need to know about keyword research. Now, I've done this across hundreds of accounts, actually over 300 accounts, and 9 times out of 10, this has beaten every single campaign that I've run based on a previous agency's campaign that they set up for single keyword ad groups and things like that. So I don't run single keyword ad groups anymore because they're just not profitable. I do get a lot of people playing and manipulating with manual CPC bids and all that kind of stuff. That's something that you can go through in your spare time, but the simpler you do it, it's kind of using the 80-20 rule, and it simplifies everything but also gets better results. So I recommend doing this structure because I've done it for a very long time and it just works. Okay, it's just using your common sense, bidding on things that you think people would be typing in to find that particular page. So no secret, that's everything that I know that I'm going to teach you here, all for free. So if you've got any questions below, leave them in the comments and I'll see you in the next video. Thanks.